Rabbi Rosenfeld, thank you. Elaine, Joshua, Dina, Gila, Brian, Alan, Elliot, wider family. It's hard to express one's feelings. From me, from Vicky, from our family, who know you so well in our community, our very, very deepest sympathy. In speaking about Rabbi Sacks, Zichron Livrocha, on this terribly sad day, I'm thinking about a man who, in the words of the Archbishop of Canterbury last night, devoted so much of his life to reflecting on God at the most profound level. I would add that he didn't just reflect, he wrote and taught until the last, making that connection with God a reality for millions around the world. Rabbi Sacks was a force for good almost without parallel in the modern Jewish world. A man of charisma and charm, even mentioning his name, especially to Americans, created a frisson of excitement. People knew him as a scholar, philosopher, a teacher, a leader, but most important, a courageous mensch. A naturally shy man who could electrify in an auditorium. This morning, I re-watched the earth-shattering short speech he gave in the House of Lords about anti-Semitism, a carefully timed intervention and writing about the oldest hatred. They have been game-changing. And he had a way, I believe, unique in our times of attracting skeptics, atheists, people deeply suspicious about rabbis and religion to engage with his unique brand of Orthodox spirituality. Rabbi Sacks embodied a concept that I discovered 25 years ago in the writings of Motzche Yosef Lehner, the Ishbitzer Rebbe, which has profoundly influenced my thinking. Yesterday, those of us who are fortunate enough to be in a shul will have heard the Akedah, the Binding of Isaac, being read. There are many interpretations, but by the late 18th century, the Hasidic thinkers see this as a challenge of the mind. Is Avraham able to learn to think in a particular way? And the Ishbitzer, a radical thinker of early 19th century Poland, reinterprets the incident. Avraham is encouraged to embrace doubt, uncertainty. Human beings, when faced with an impossible contradiction of the sort that Avraham experienced, have a natural tendency to shy away, to parse what is going on in their lives. In simple terms, God must want A but not B, or B but not A, or to put the duvet over our heads and be paralyzed entirely by the uncertainty. For the Ishbitzer, the challenge of the Akedah was for Avraham to recognize that he could have a meaningful spiritual life, to progress and continue notwithstanding the uncertainty, to embrace it, and even using a word that Rabbi Sacks was fond of, anti-fragile, meaning to grow from the experience of dealing with a difficulty. We were blessed that in this era, Rabbi Sacks, Rabban Shel Kol Yisrael, we were granted a teacher who personified this idea. He never shied away from difficult issues. He never claimed that faith and Jewish practice were straightforward in a post-Enlightenment epistemological framework. He was fearless in tackling tough issues and unfashionable subjects, morality, sexuality, faith, overbaked deconstructionism, and his bête noire, moral relativism. There was no thinker, speaker, author, or advocate that he wouldn't take on and win in his own inimitable way. This meant he was able to expand the tent of faith and adherence to orthodoxy beyond what anyone could imagine. And in this, Rabbi Sacks, Mori Varebi, was a modern day Avraham, allowing, empowering, and even giving permission for people to believe and practice Judaism, even when they aren't sure and might never be sure. There's been a consistent message from the rabbinate since the awful news began to spread last night. The overwhelming message is, Rabbi Sacks was there for me. He gave me support and encouragement. He helped me out when I had a personal crisis. He was there when something went wrong in my professional life. He supported hundreds of rabbis and others in his own UK rabbinate and further afield in his quiet, understated way. His impact on the rabbinate is incalculable, and the void caused by his passing unfathomable. I learned many things from him. Vicky and I had the enormous zechus to get to know Rabbi Sacks and Tibod L'chaim Arukim Elaine as we were the rabbi and rebbetzin of their shul for the past 7 years, as personal friends and as active, engaged congregants. And it's been an inspiration, repeating some of the things that my colleagues have said, to watch Jonathan and Elaine's relationship, their love, their closeness, the support, the extraordinary bond between them, their openness, both in personal relationships and even in interviews in the press, and their overwhelming love for their children and grandchildren, and to see it all close up. I can only imagine the pain. Few Dunstan Roaders will forget Rabbi Sacks jumping on his chair on the night of Simchas Torah, singing Horderes Ve'emunah and shouting in Yiddish to the astonishment of people. Then he buttoned his jacket back up and kind of went home immediately afterwards. And at the Templeton Award ceremony, the austere organisers were astonished when he broke into song, of course, Oseh Sholem, as was already mentioned. And I won't forget, Elaine, you might remember, that I gave a drosha in honour of his 70th birthday. And in the drosha, I said the following. Dunstan Road must be the only place in the world where the most famous rabbi in the world is the stand-in when the rabbi's on holiday. The following Shabbos, the chazan began and he had a coughing fit and I stood in. And afterwards, Rabbi Sacks came up to me and he said, you know, Dunstan Road's also the only shul in the world where the rabbi's the stand-in for the chazan. My personal relationship with Rabbi Sacks meant more to me than I can say. And it's been a tremendous spur to my personal and professional development. In my role as chief strategist of University Jewish Chaplaincy, of which he was co-founder and life president, he was encouraging and always deeply interested in the challenges of Jewish students, especially around assimilation and anti-Zionism. He spoke at our second son's bar mitzvah, and at our daughter's wedding 2 years ago, he accepted the brocha achrita. He took the cup and looked at me and said, I've never done this before, how do you do it? The most eloquent spokesman for Judaism of our generation, the preeminent global Jewish voice, he raised the profile of the United Synagogue and of British Jewry worldwide. We, the rabbinate, we were in awe of him and so proud that he was our chief rabbi and then afterwards our ambassador to the world. In many senses, all modern Jews are students of Rabbi Sacks, whether they know it or not, whether they acknowledge it or not, or whether they like it or not. And I'm reminded of a Satma Chosid who came to see me in his Shmona Begodim, one Shushan Purim. I don't know why he wanted to come. And he sat there and he said he was beginning to struggle with ideas outside the box in which he had grown up. And he said, I've started to read the writings of that Rabbi Sacks. And this had transformed his world. Despite his genius, and it was genius, he was always willing to learn. I was thrilled last year that on the drosha on Shmini Atzeres, he quoted a book that I'd recommended in the drosha, and he often asked me for sources I'd cited that he hadn't heard before. No one ever had an ordinary interaction with him. He was a man who could influence people's lives with a single interaction and with a twinkle in his eye. And some of you may have seen a message sent by the very well-known Anglican Giles Fraser, who's a close friend of mine, who Giles and Lynn ate a while ago with Jonathan Lane at our house. And you may remember dancing with his children. Giles has Jewish children with a Jewish wife. And this has absolutely transformed the way in which they're bringing up their children to give them a Jewish content in their lives. Extraordinary. Elaine, Joshua, Dina, Gila, Brian, Alan and Elliot, we, your community, the rabbinate, British Jewry, and all who care about right and wrong and morality, share your loss and your pain as the world mourns along with you. 30 years ago, Rabbi Sacks spoke about what was important to him. and of institutions, buildings, and books, he chose books because they endure. And despite his sad and untimely passing, his many books, broadcasts, his lucidity, his extraordinary ability to distill complex ideas into meaningful, inspirational content for a broad audience will all live on. The loss is immeasurable, but the light that Rabbi Lord Sacks casts in every corner of the globe, his astonishing creativity, these are the legacy of a once-in-a-generation towering, transcendent figure whom none of us will ever forget. His paths and words will forever remain an inspiration. Zechusa yogein oleinu v'al kol Yisrael al biyas goel tzedek mimhevi omeinu v'noimar omein.